Here at Google, we want to make it easier for news organizations to deepen their relationship with their most loyal readers while increasing their revenue. My name's Ariana Palumbo. I'm a partner operations manager at Google, where I focus on a technology product called Reader Revenue Manager. In this short video, we'll take a closer look at that product, which was built by Google to make it easier to get your reader revenue business off the ground. Reader Revenue Manager is a self-service platform that helps news organizations launch, test, and manage a subscriptions or contributions model on their desktop and mobile web pages. The product also includes several additional features that help increase reader engagement and retention, such as newsletter signup, surveys, and reader registration. It's specifically designed for small and medium-sized news organizations who don't have an existing memberships model in place. And the best part is, it doesn't require any coding. With Reader Revenue Manager, you can choose the revenue model that fits your needs. The platform allows you to experiment with selling subscriptions by gating some or all content behind a paywall, accepting voluntary contributions, or collecting first-party data from your readers, which is becoming increasingly important in a privacy-first world. Now, let's walk through a few of the benefits of using the product that we're excited to share. One, Reader Revenue Manager highlights your news coverage across Search, Discover, and Google News to active subscribers or contributors. This not only drives traffic, but also reinforces the value of your publication to your audience. Two, Reader Revenue Manager is easy to set up and should take no more than just a few days to implement. For some publishers, it's taken just a couple of hours. Three, it removes payment friction. With Reader Revenue Manager, you can convert readers in just two clicks using our fast and secure checkout experience. Your readers will also stay signed in everywhere they're logged into their Google accounts. Reader Revenue Manager allows you to connect directly with your audience. When a user signs up for a newsletter or registers, you'll have direct access to your readers' opted-in contact information. When they submit a survey, you'll be able to generate first-party audience data that you can either view in Google Analytics or pass automatically to Google Ad Manager for improved ads monetization. This data is private, secure, and will never be processed by Google. In addition to these benefits, there is no cost to implement Reader Revenue Manager. There's a fixed 5% transaction fee for payments, inclusive of all credit card fees, and you get to keep the other 95%. Reader Revenue Manager is a new product that's still evolving, so it's important to note that there are a few instances where we would not recommend using Reader Revenue Manager. This includes if you're a nonprofit, if you want to sell subscriptions on your mobile app, if you have an existing paid membership or subscription model in place, or if your site is built entirely on AMP, among other cases. Now, let's take a look at the two revenue models you can implement with Reader Revenue Manager. You can monetize your content either by offering subscriptions or contributions. With subscriptions, your audience can access your paywalled content with a recurring payment plan. These plans can vary based on factors like length. For example, you might offer two pricing plans, one that's monthly and another that's annual. When it comes to subscriptions, the incentive for paying is clear. Payment basically allows a user to access your content. You can also set up metered access to premium content for new users or users who register with their Google accounts. Putting your content behind a paywall, however, can hurt reader engagement and advertising revenue. Okay, now let's turn to contributions. With contributions, your audience can voluntarily contribute to your site, but still access your content even if they decide not to. Contributions can be either recurring or one-time. Because they're optional, however, there's less of an incentive to pay, and so we tend to see that contribution plans generate less conversions than subscription plans. On the flip side, unlike subscriptions, contributions tend to have no impact on reader engagement or advertising revenue. Ultimately, it's really up to your news organization to decide which is a better fit. Our recommendation is to test out a contribution model first, gather a strong base that contributes, and then consider building out a subscription model. In addition to launching a paywall or accepting contributions, there are a number of other features you can implement using Reader Revenue Manager to help build out your first-party data strategy. With surveys, you can prompt your readers to answer a series of simple questions. You can then use this first-party data from your readers to improve ad targeting or user experience. With our newsletter sign-up tool, you can collect reader email addresses and opt them into your existing newsletter mailing service. And finally, with reader registration, you can turn new readers into registered readers and grant additional access to premium content for those who register. Reader Revenue Manager is a new product that continues to evolve. If you have any questions about any of the features mentioned or just need help with your setup, don't hesitate to contact our support team. Now, let's walk through how to get started. First, create your publication in Publisher Center. If you've never done this before, be sure to check out our video on Publisher Center. After you add your publication, go to the homepage and under Explore Products, select Reader Revenue Manager to get started. Okay, what's next? At a high level, there are three key steps you need to complete. First, you'll select your preferred content access strategy. If you do decide to implement a revenue model, you'll need to set up pricing and create your payments profile. Second, you'll need to add the Reader Revenue Manager code snippet to your website. And finally, you'll add your logo, policy links, verify a few details, and then activate your publication. As you go through your setup, here are a few best practices to keep in mind. For subscriptions, determine which of your offers is the best option and draw attention to it by adding language like Reader's Choice or Best Value to the subscription name. Offer a trial, but limit it to only one of your subscription offerings. In other words, if you have two or more subscription options, only one of those options should feature a trial. Consider offering benefits like newsletters or subscribers-only events. Now for contributions, give choices. Offer a variety of billing options for contributions such as one-time, monthly, and annual. Set monthly donations as your default. Next, set reminders. If you increase your contribution request frequency to high, readers will be shown a prompt every 1 to 3 visits. In both cases, for subscriptions and contributions, you should include the ability to cancel at any time. This reassures the user that they know they can change their mind at any point. For more information on how to set up Reader Revenue Manager, please check out our Help Center. That's all for this video. If you have any questions about setting up Reader Revenue Manager or need help troubleshooting any technical issues, please use this form to contact our support team. The Google News Initiative also provides in-depth coaching for news organizations through our labs. You can learn more and sign up on our website at g.co/newsinitiatives/labs. Feel free to also send any feedback or questions to contactgni@google.com.